Started. So this video is going to be a hair tutorial, and it is going to be on this hair that I had done in my last video, What's in My Purse. I got so many requests to do this video, so I thought that I would do it, and I was so happy to because this is my total go-to hairdo when I don't want to do my hair, when it's greasy, etc. I do want to let you guys know that I'm sorry about the echo. It is pretty echoey in here, but I'm in my bathroom. I wanted to do it in my bathroom for you guys, and I hope that's okay. Thirdly, the few things that you are going to need, I use obviously your hairbrush. I use two little hair ties because my hair is very thin. And then the third hair tie that I use is this. So when I part my hair to do each side, this one side can be held by the big hair tie. And that is about it. I hope you guys like this video and you guys subscribe if you guys would like to see more. But without further ado, let's get started. So, welcome to my bathroom. First of all, the first thing that I'm going to do is take my hair down. So this is my hair length. It's pretty short. It's been up in a ponytail all day, which is why it looks kind of bad. But this is the hair that I have. The first thing that I'm gonna do is take out my brush. I have always hated combs. I don't know why, I just don't think they are very helpful. I just have never found them useful. I like big brushes to just get the job done, you know what I'm saying? So the first thing that I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and redo my part. I want my part to be right down the center because I am gonna be doing two braids. Finding the center in the back is always the hardest for me, so I just use my little, I have this little mirror, and I go like this, and when I'm finding it, I do that, and then just to make sure that I did it right. So once I do that, I'm going to take my first hair tie, my first big hair tie, and just tie it off. Oh, that is beautiful. Oh yeah, look at that. First time's a charm. I've gotten pretty professional at this, not gonna lie. Then I'm gonna just dampen my brush, brushing a little bit of water into my hair just so it's a little bit easier to get the strands of hair free. This hair tutorial is a French braid hair tutorial. So if you don't know how to French braid, I can also do tutorials on that. But I'm gonna start off by just doing a basic French braid from the corner right here and just begin to do my French braid. So the whole reason that I do a ponytail at the end, one, it's nice because you don't have to finish off the braid, and two, my hair is so short that it's just easier to do that, period. I'm gonna do it slow so it looks super good for you guys, but when I do this, I do it super fast. I'll do it in the car sometimes. Like, it's a super easy hair tutorial. I didn't know how to French braid for the longest time. I actually just learned this year. I used to just depend so much on like someone else doing it for me, and then once I realized I had no one at home to do it for me, I was like, wait, I need to learn. I literally sat down on YouTube and I would watch like Dutch braiding tutorials, like French braiding tutorials, and I just like crazy learned how to braid, and I just practice. I practice all the time. You can't do anything else to get good at braiding. You just have to keep practicing to get good at it. Then
once I finish the French braid, I'm gonna take my mini hair tie and go ahead and tie it right at the end of my hairline. I'm gonna brush it out. And this is not the finished product, so once I do this side, it still won't be totally done. There's still like another step. So then I'm gonna do this side. I'm so sorry, you guys. I like didn't even change my shirt. I probably look so raggedy. It depends on what occasion I'm going to. Like if I really need my hair back and out of my face, I'll do the French braids that go up, like and back. But these are more to the side. Does that make sense? I know when I first started French braiding, I couldn't even consider doing braids up and over my head. They always just ended up around my ear. And that's just what happened because I didn't know that repositioning, like I had to practice repositioning my hands. My second small hair tie and do the same thing to this one. I'm just gonna end it right where my hairline and the braid ends. I'm gonna double check that line in the back just to make sure. Oh yeah, see that? That's really bad. Hold on, what happened here? Okay, that's whatever. I give up. It's gonna be a messy hairdo anyways. So this is, we're almost done here. So this is the braids and the pigtails. I just make sure that the braids, I try to make sure that the pigtails are even just so that way one's not longer than the other. I brush them out a little bit so they're not rag-taggy. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start at the bottom here and I'm gonna take from what I can feel each loop of the braid and pull it out. Each one out. It's gonna make the hairdo way messier and it's gonna pull this hair out, but that's just kind of what comes with the hairdo. And then I'm gonna take my mirror here and I'm gonna look and see if I missed any of these loops, if one isn't as long as another. It looks pretty even in the back. And then I'm just gonna really pull out these ones in the front. And then I'm gonna go ahead and tighten my ponytail at the end. Make sure that it's not falling out because we did just pull a bunch of hair out of it and I don't want it to pull out. Once you do that, the back is gonna become a little bit messier. There's no avoiding that. The hair is just kind of gonna come out. You guys can see the difference. So this is the side that I pulled all the loops out, and then this is the side that I didn't. So obviously there is a very big difference. You can definitely finish the braids out and pull apart all the braids like leading up to it so they're thicker braids. I just can't do that because when I do braid all the way through, my braids kind of curl up and I feel like I'm Cindy Lou Who. So just because my hair is short. So as per short hair, it's easier if you do it this way. So I'm just gonna go ahead and start to do the same thing to the other side and just pull those loops out. I have like a braid crown with the little pigtails at the end. This is the finished look. I want to thank you guys so much for watching. I remember searching on YouTube everywhere and I was like, I cannot find anything online of anyone putting like short hair braiding and like stuff tutorials because I feel like there's not a lot you can do with short hair. But I do things like this all the time that are different that I didn't find online. I'm a Pinterest fanatic too, so I totally look online and do all that stuff.
So if you guys would like to see a short hair, like 10 different styles that are easy, quick.
Guys, I'm so sorry to say, I didn't realize, but my camera died while I was recording. I just want to thank you guys so much for watching, and if you would like a hair tutorial in the future, please feel free to let me know in the comments down below or by liking this video. Otherwise, I would love it if you would subscribe, and I will see you guys in a few days with my next video. Have a great day, guys. Bye.